Hey, Lovebugs, it's Roslyn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored, and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time stopping by my channel, much love to you and welcome into my returning subs, my growing, extended, beautiful family. Thank you for just the support, being able to know you can look at things in a different perspective so you can be able to elevate yourself as well as evolve into the person you were always truly supposed to be. So with that being said, much love to all. Namaste. Love and blessings. Love and light. And many blessings are definitely coming your way. And if you have been watching my videos for a while and have not already, please like and subscribe. Even hit that notification bell so you know when I'm about to upload my next video. Also, if you are comfortable enough, please drop me a line or two. I love a chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me, even if it's about the positive feedback of the content of my video, or you're just up telling me about your empathic gift and how it impacted your life and heading you towards a positive direction. Also, if you are feeling like the videos gave you good vibes or good information that you would love to share with a loved one, family, or friend that's going through some dark times and need confirmation or validation towards their life path or even their soul purpose, please go ahead and share. And while you're at it, give me a thumbs up, like, and also share on your social media favorites wherever you see fit. And once again, thank you so much for the love and support. It's so greatly appreciated. And I love you from the bottom of my heart. And I hope you're able to resonate with the content of my video. And this beautiful meditation I'm listening to, I love this one. It always sticks out to me. They're in a lotus position. And it's like, I don't know why I get, you know, those really stick out to me. Either it's like the binaural beats, theta beats, or, you know, the Buddha images, or the people who are doing the lotus, you know, position. Those are always the ones I usually love to listen to. It's called Ultimate Seven Chakra Meditation, or Healing, Releasing Blocks, and Creating Flow. So I will post that link in the description box below. And my video today is about Twin Flame 101. Hey, Opus, make sure you do your weeding in your garden so the growth vibes can flow through. And that's so true. That's just like if you have a garden at home, or if you have a yard that you tend to, you know, you have to always get the bad weeds out, you know, so, you know, the grass can, you know, evenly come through, or it can even look, you know, attractive. You know, so it's just like, I always tell people, you know, I even tell my children, it's like how you keep your house is how, you know, people can see you. You know, if you keep a good house and a clean, you know, clean inside and out, that lets you know you're a clean person or whatever. But it's just like things out on the place, you can tell how people keep themselves up. It's really not good. So it's just like going through all these different things, you know, you need to take out of your life, you know, really step back and look at your life in all different directions, all different perspectives, especially when you are going to that new chapter in your life. I know I might be talking about that a lot, but there's a lot of us are going to that different chapter in life. You know, we're healing from a lot of things that was traumatizing towards us, that has stunted our growth, that, you know, blocked our blessings, slowing down our blessings because of the things that we allowed to really get to us when it was really supposed to teach us, heal us, and move on. Also, trust me, I messed up myself up a lot of times because I always released anger and still talking about the same things over and over again, which is like, you know what, you sound redundant. You go on to bigger and better things. You want these bigger and better things. You can't keep on talking about the same things that has put you in that dark place as it is. Like, I can use an example, but I'll just, you know, use this quick snippet and say, you know what, you know, I can really look at this situation as a blessing no longer than a curse. Because it's like, yeah, we go through things that's really traumatized us. Yes, we have. We all have. You know, if you're watching my videos, obviously you've been through some really rough stuff. You know, and you're just trying to find a way of healing, putting meaning to the things that you are experiencing right now. You know, and it's like I said, it's a blessing for me to be able to, you know, do these videos. Being able to help people in so many different spiritual aspects is truly a blessing to me. Being able to know my story on what I'm opening up to tell people can allow people to make sense of the crazy stuff that occurs in their life. And being able to know you are able to heal. You know, you're all able to let go. We're all able to evolve. You know, you're supposed to go to another level of happiness, to spirituality, oneness. You know, if you've got a twin flame, you're heading towards your unions. You're healing yourself in so many different ways and loving yourself and finding yourself worthy of all the things that are, you know, trying to come towards you. Because a lot of times, like I said before, that I know new people are coming in, there's a lot of times where we have been damaged so bad. When blessings come through, we always feel like it has hidden motives, or we feel like we don't deserve that, or we feel like it's not real, or we feel like, you know, things are always going to be that way, because it's like when something new comes in, it doesn't have any hidden motives, it's just pure blessings because they felt like you needed them. It's going to be like a shock to you. Like, dang, did I deserve this? Or, you know, is this real? You know, there can be really, you know, there can be stuff that really goes on in your life. And it's just like, well, dang, you know, we're trying to give you these blessings, but you feel like you're not worthy of them. And there's a lot of people that do that, and that's a sad situation. But it's like when you want all those things to be able to come through, you have to be able to look at your life at a positive, you know, outcome. Like, okay, I've been through hell and back. I got frequent flyer miles. I even have a passport going there. Yeah, that's fine. But if you know that, you know what, I've been through hell and back, but I deserve to be happy. I'm heading towards bigger things, and I see, you know, blessings coming to me at all sizes. The little ones I'm grateful for, the big ones I'm really grateful for, and even the ones that haven't got here yet, I'm grateful for those too. And I, you know, you always have to show the universe you're always happy, you know, for the things that comes to your life. You know, even, you know, you're trying to figure out, like today, I had no money. And I was trying to figure out, how am I going to be able to feed my fur babies outside, you know? And it was just like, next thing you know, I checked my account, and I was just like, oh, I got a couple of dollars and stuff like that. So I can go get that. And I told God, thank you. I mean, it was just like a few dollars for me to get the things that I need to get. But that's just a blessing, you know, for you to have that little bit of money you had come in, just for all that stuff. And I was just like, you know what, that is a straight blessing, and I choose to be grateful for that. You know, no, you know, the old days, I'm like, well, dang, I could at least got more than that. That you can't be that way. You can't be ungrateful, you know. And I had a bad habit of being ungrateful in the past. That's why I look at it, you know what, thank you for that. You didn't have to give me that, but thank you. Because I was really panicking, because I always, you know, I got two in the house, and I got 8 or 9 of them outside that, you know, came with my house. And I love them just like I love the ones outside. And it's just, the more I get into my empathic ways, you know, I feel like that. I know there was even somebody put a post up a few days ago, do you feel like animals have a soul? I'm like, yes, they do. I mean, I've seen, you know, dogs and cats cry, and that broke my heart just to see that they had to go through that, because it's sad. They don't know how, they only can communicate with you to a certain extent when you're trying to see what's wrong with them. It's like, if they're sick, they really can't tell you what's wrong with them. That's a sad situation. But when you're an empath, you feel like everything that connects has a soul. They have feelings, you know. Even trees, you know, they cut them down, you feel bad for them cutting them down, because it's like, you know, that's the way of life, that's the circle of life. But all these different things. But it's just like, when you know, when you're in your garden, you want nice, beautiful flowers. You want it to be immaculate. You want to be able to say, you know what, I'm proud of my yard. You know, honestly, I'm really proud of my yard. It's just like with me, with my ex, you know, I've been wanting him to do certain things to mine. But it's like me, I'm allergic to almost damn near everything outside. So it's like, I can't get a hold of things, and I get frustrated. I'm like, hey, can you get that? Because, you know, I can't get it because I'm allergic to it. You know, and I've always been like that since I was a child. I was allergic to grass, allergic to daggone beach water. And I'm like, what are you, beach water? I can't stick myself in bleach water. I mean, beach water, because it like burns my skin. And, you know, it's just like very sensitive. So it's just like, you know, I'm just like, dang, you know, I love nature, but, you know, nature kicks my butt. So it's just like all these different things that, you know, you're heading towards. Pay attention to what goes and flows in and out of your life. You know, pay attention to the circle that you choose to hang around. Is it something healthy? Are you growing from this certain situation? Are they growing off of you? You know, are they, you know, are they bettering your life? You know, as I said, I try to keep people in my life that are, you know, they're evolving. You know, they're trying to go, they got a goal they trying to get to, and I got a goal I'm trying to get to, even though I hate saying goals. But there's things that you're trying to reach. You know, if you can send me some encouraging stuff, I daggone sure give you encouragement as well. I'm not that type of person to just say these things and be jabbing you in the back, because they have people like that. You have to be very aware of them nasty, nasty people. So it's just like, anything that's coming into your life, you have to monitor. Whether it has, you know, with me, I'm just trying to, you know, change my eating habits. So you have to, you know, be aware of the things that are coming in and out of your body, the way you're going about things, you know, how you look at different things, how you respond to it, you know, being grateful for everything that's coming in and out of your life. You know, even when, God and universe shines a light on people that are not supposed to be in your life. You have to be grateful and say thank you for that, especially when you ask them, hey, can you allow me to see the unseen of the things that are not supposed to be in my life, that abuses me, lies to me, and hurts me behind closed doors? And then when they start showing you all these different people, like, God, no, are you serious? Okay. Cut. You know, I don't even ask, you know, like I said before, I used to ask questions about stuff like that. Now I don't even question. I'll just get you out of my life, and you just, you know, like I said before, that you don't even realize that was your last time talking to me. Whenever that last time was, that was your last time. Before, I used to give people explanations, and I don't even do that no more. Hey, it is what it is. If you step over my boundaries, like I tell people, I love doing one-on-ones, but I have a boundary. If I tell you to, hey, chat with me at 9:30, between after 9:30 in the morning, Eastern Standard Time, 10:30 at night, Eastern Standard Time, anything after that, like if I chat with you, that's a different story, you know, because if I might have sent something, I'm like, okay, well, I'll allow that to happen. Or there's people that are overseas, then, you know, I allow that to happen. But other than that, if you do that and I have to keep telling you, I'm just going to block you, because I don't have to sit up here and tell you too many times to respect my boundaries. If you don't respect my boundaries, and I'm not trying to be mean about it, but you have to be, there's times I, you know, I want to spend time with my kids. There's times I might, you know, have company and I'm trying to spend time with them. I don't have time to be jumping back and forth on this unless it's like an extreme emergency, and I'm not talking about your extreme emergency. Like, oh my God, my boyfriend doesn't want to deal with me. Baby, you got to deal with stuff like that on your own, because I ain't even got no man. Or I ain't even, you know, if you're dealing with stuff like that, especially if you're married, because it's just a fact that your wife or somebody see you texting me at that time of night, and they look at me, hey, I don't need your type of drama coming over here, because I don't want you like that. We just friends. I don't need that type of drama in my life. But you have to be able to put boundaries up. People can't respect your boundaries, respect your privacy, you know, then those are the people you need to cut out your life. I mean, there's people that sit up here, you know, and I hate the fact that, you know, Facebook has changed that, because you used to be able to change it to where if you want to call people voice or video chat, now they're allowing anybody that you talk to can be able to get in touch with you. Like, I don't like that, because it's like, okay, just because I send you something doesn't mean I want to talk on the phone with you that time. At least ask me, hey, are you free for me to call you or something like that? Then I'll respect that more. But if you just up and call me without even asking me, that's an automatic block just right there. Because I'm just like, unless you're like, oh, my bad, I didn't mean to do that, because that has happened to me before. I accidentally did that towards somebody. But it's like, you have to be able to, you know, that's when you know. Because some people just walk all over you if you're allowed to do that. But if the people don't respect you in your space, get them out. Because that's the time I'm telling you, you really need to weed out stuff that's in your life. Because, you know, some people are just, you know, narcissistic like that and want to control things. Because, like, I've seen people, you tell them, oh, I got to be gone at this certain time, and they'll keep talking to you and talking to you because they messed up, because they feel like their time is more important than your time. Then, you know, you need to set free. So being able to pay attention to all the things, because you can't go about life like you used to go about life. You're on a whole new different chapter, so you have to find a whole new different way on routine on how to do things. So if you know that you have blessings coming to a flow, allow the things that are not, you know, are not flying right with you or not meeting eye to eye to let go. Make peace with love with them. You know, that's why I said, just say, just let it go with love. So I hope you were able to resonate with the content in this video. Drop me a line. I would love to hear the feedback on, you know, your side of this situation. And drop me a line, give me a thumbs up, share, like, and subscribe, even hit that bell. Know that you are truly blessed, highly favored, and forever loved, and know there's always somebody out there praying for your better days. And I will give a post notification shout out to Mimi, Daquan Bradley, and Elena Carter. Much love to you, and I'll see you in my next video. Much love, peace, be wild.